So this week has been pretty crazy. I think we've had 18 horses out from the yard at a couple of different events. And it started the week on Tuesday at Aston Le Walls with 5 novices. And that was a good day. We were really pleased with that. And a couple did their first novices. And on the whole, very pleasing. I think all was good. I managed to have a rail down on, I think, all of them apart from one. And who the one that was clear was Coolie Can Do, lovely little mare, who finished second in her novice. And the others all went really well. And I was delighted with my first timers. I thought it was a nice course, and they just had a canter round. I quite like with the 6-year-olds that are starting their novices, or young horses that are starting novices, ones that can be green enough or something. Like I had a horse called Brookfield Future News, and he has done 200s with me this year, and he was nearly ready for a novice. And I just thought one more 100 would set him up nicely. So I entered him into Kelsall on the Friday in the 100 to then not leave him too long before he then ran in his first novice 4 or 5 days later. So they haven't got too long to get too fresh again or forget their job, what they are learning at the minute. And so I was delighted with him. I thought he had a lovely ride round. And I find with the 6-year-olds when they're starting novices, it's actually one of the most important stages of their careers, of thinking it can be enough of a step up from 100 to novices with some of the courses. The courses can vary a bit, but I always think it's one of the biggest step ups of their career when they're young horses and they're learning. So I quite often, whatever their dressage score, whatever the ground, like to just give them slower runs to just know what they're doing, have time to think about it, and, you know, have a good experience and not be pushing them for the time when they're still just a little bit green and might just want to, you know, find their feet at a slightly bigger step up, to keep them calm and keep them educating in a positive and confident way. And so I had a couple that I was delighted with that took the step up really well and felt that I did as good a job as I could to just to try and educate them nicely, that they came home thinking that was a cool day. And I will continue probably with their next couple of novice runs to just keep it a little bit steady, to just to make sure that they know knowing their job. So on the whole, that day was a good day. And then we went back there on the Wednesday with 100, who I rode a little horse called Bodie, who is actually another full thoroughbred owned by Jane McGiven. And I have the ride on him at the minute because dear little Irish Susie Berry got kicked in the arm hand grazing, so broke her arm, which is a disaster. And because we share the same owner, I said that I would happily take him on for her to keep her going until Sue's gets back. And, you know, I have to say full credit to Sue's, because we had Bodie in our yard as a 4-year-old when he first came out of racing. And she has done an absolutely wonderful job on a young horse and turning him around from a racehorse to an event horse. And all credit to her, because I've just picked up the reins very last minute, and knowing the horse well in the past from at the races, he was a very stressy horse at the races and kind of ran his race before he got to the track, of being in a white lather before he even made it to the out of the parade ring. And a confident, very happy horse that really does enjoy the eventing. And so full credit to her. She has done an amazing job. But what a cute little horse he is as well. You know, yes, he's had all the right work to get there. But what a lovely little type, great mover. and jumped, you know, really very well, made a great shape, felt very careful, very impressive, to be honest. And so I'm not trying to have a yard full of racehorses, because I know after the last one, little Polo, who's a dear little chap, and God knows what he, you know, where he ends up. But, you know, it is great to see that they can have a job, and some of them really are actually, you know, can be event horses and could be quite good event horses. So it's, you know, it is great for the retraining of those guys to see some come through and actually really, really enjoy it. If they've got the brain for it and have the right management and help, that they can go on to do well. Because Bodie, actually, he did win his class that day on a 23 point something dressage and was an absolute pleasure and felt like a really cool little horse. But like I say, you know, well done, Suze, for all she's done. She's given him the time and been very patient, and she's done a very, very good job. And then we moved on to Cirencester, which is a new event in the calendar. So I had five of the old boys, the OIs, that ran there. They ran at Burnham last time. I was, you know, concerned that the ground might be coming up hard enough and not wanting to give them too many bigger runs on the hard ground. However, it had rained and the ground when we got there was very good. And so it was nice for them to all have a run of some sort, some quicker than others, always a personal preference of where they're at. They don't always need to go flat out. And I felt with some, they had a good spin and a couple of wins with Sportsfield Top Notch, who's a lovely up and coming horse who's run, just stepped up to advanced level. So it's always great. I like giving them a confident spin afterwards, which he didn't feel like he really needed. He was out of the start box like a bullet and flew round happy as Larry. So that was great. And Brookfield Inocent was totally on his own game and fine. And like I said, my mistake at Burnham is always very good, just to put you back on your toes and say, oi, come here, we've got a job to do. But he was spot on, and all worries gone there. So that was great to be at a new event. Definitely one that I'll go back to. Well done to those guys. And I think a really smart venue that hopefully will get a lot of people, being where it's at, that come into the venue to come and watch it over the years. So I think it will be a successful event. And then I went back on the Saturday with just some two stars, of which Coolie Can Do had a second, which was very exciting at her, at that level for her. Such a cute little mare. She's coming along really nicely for Julie Oldis and Anne Tolhurst, and you know, she's such fun and a horse that I am excited about for the future. And our old fella is, he did his first two star short, and he did a sweet little dressage for a 31 and jumped his little socks off in the jumping for one down. But my God, did he feel like a right little dinger. I was like, he's definitely going to go further than this level. But we got quick down one line, the triple bar run down, four strides to the vertical, just slightly caught us out. But no, he felt great. And the thing is with him, you know, he wasn't in, it was a very competitive class, one rail sort of drops you 20 places. And so with him at the minute, he's brave and he's fast and he really wants to go. But there have got to be some days that he just has a slow run, because it'd be a horse that I could easily lose his mind and him do things without really thinking what he's done. And so it's just very important to me on the days that he doesn't need to, you know, he's not going to be in the top few, that he definitely is educated well and has a slow run to just keep producing him mentally and keeping the confidence there to actually know what they're thinking about and what they're doing. So that is what this week was about. It was a long week. It was a tiring week, to be honest. But well done the guys on the yard. All those horses turned out and done. I think I spoke to Ames on Saturday morning and was like, how many hours sleep did you have last night? And she said 3. So I was like, that's great, from finishing Cirencester at God knows what time, I think 6:30 on Friday, to get home at 10, to then have left by 4:30 or something on the Saturday. Sometimes we question our sanity, but no, they do a sterling job. And what was great of the Saturday as well, my sister went for an advanced on a horse that she's produced all the way time for Harry, and had a brilliant second place, which really was exciting for us because we had a bit of a disaster at Burnham, and it just went wrong in the show jumping. And do you know what? It just can be so hard sometimes with just one horse at a higher level. And the pressure that we put on ourselves of just one horse, one go. And it is hard when you don't have a string. And I do, you know, we do take our hats off to all those guys that do try to do it at one, with one horse at one level, of keeping your eye in and keeping in the groove, as it were. And she was so down at Burnham that, is this what she should be doing and all the rest of it? And she picked herself up and gave herself a kick up the backside as well, and kicked on and had a right result of second place behind Kitty King. So good on her. And just goes to show, if you keep picking yourself up and go, you just never know. And it was a brilliant result and we're all very excited. Anyway, hopefully the cold weather can bugger off at some stage, because we'd like it to just start warming up and feel a bit like spring or summer. And yes, that would be nice. But onwards, this week is a quieter week at home with just Kiso before we start a monster Aston Le Walls, of which I think we've got. We are out 7 days, every day at Aston for 7 days. And then Thomas thought it was even a great idea to take the babies to the unaffiliated on the 8th day, which went down like a shit sandwich. But I think I think we probably do. It would be a really good event for the babies, so we've got to go and do that. So a week at Aston Le Walls the following week, 8 whole days. Anyway, until then, see you then. Bye bye.